Please listen to this before the video I'm bringing to you. It has come to our notice that we are being shadow banned and it is being sponsored by this government of APC. And it's not just our platform, some other platform, selected platform that they believe is anti-APC platforms are being shadow banned so that you and the rest of Nigerians will not be getting the truth the way they are. What will you do? Just keep sharing the video, keep liking them so that the video will keep breaking their sponsored shadow ban. Viewers and subscribers, so welcome back again. This is Toby VI Channel 1, where we tell you the hardcore truth, given this impunity of a government sleepless night. I can tell you that it is trending, you know, what Mike did by humiliating newly appointed permanent secretaries to come and bow before the demigod in Asorok.
Today, most of them have never dreamt in their life that they will ever get to the peak of their career. That is very, very important, not just the infrastructure every day. So if you permit me, I don't know those beneficiaries, the permanent secretaries, I don't know where they are here. Come out, come out. You are the beneficiary, come out. You are supposed to be the agent of renewal, but come out. Both women, both men, everyone. First year and take a bow before Mr. President, the lucky ones. Your Excellency, these are the first set of permanent secretaries that you made. Head of service, are you not the permanent secretary? And that is their head of service, Your Excellency. These are the technical tip down that we have. So I want to sincerely thank you. Now, most of them have been going to churches and mosques. They have been praying now that God should help them to be head of service. But it was not there before. For them to be head of service, it was not available. But now you have made it available.
Good. Since after this video, Nigerians have been, you know, beating them left, right, and center. And I can tell you the truth, two things are involved in this video. It is either these people are not qualified to attain that position, and those who are qualified undermined because of the corruption of the system. Or these people have no other option than to play to the gallery, because after giving 25 years of service to attain to the point of being appointed permanent secretary, you are being humiliated and subjected to this kind of treatment by this government, who believe that they have captured the soul of this country. To be honest with you, I can tell you the fact. You can take it home. These two things are what is involved. Either they are not qualified and being appointed on the basis of corruption and undermining those who are qualified because it's a political staff, or they don't have any other option than to submit themselves, because these people have believed they have captured the soul of the state. Now keep that aside. On the other hand, we can continue in his balablo.
After the years, sometimes it is good to bring the pictorial picture of what was, so people can appreciate it. Now the road is done, nobody would know how it was. So I've told him that next time you should be able to show the picture so that people understand, appreciate what you have been able to do. And I believe by the grace of God that people here will appreciate. In fact, I don't want to talk politics now, but I do know it will be difficult. It will be difficult for anybody to challenge you in FCT. It will be very, very difficult. Very, very difficult. Well, I dare say so, because the facts are there, the things are there. It's not about theory now, it's about the reality. You say you will do this, have you done it? Yes. You say you will do this, has he done it? Yes. So what are we talking about again? So I sincerely thank you, and I want to plead with you.
Good. You heard him. This man thought that Abuja is like River State, where he rigged the election, where he was the Jagaban as at that time, And thank God, Fubara is giving it to him, woto woto. But nevertheless, we want to remind Nweke that Abuja is not River State. The factors that played out in River State will never play out in Abuja. And I can go and take it home. The kind of thought you unleashed, will not play out in Abuja come next to the 2027 election. God help you. If Peter Obi is on the ballot, you will receive the shocker of your life. If APC could lose Aso Rock, where they are holding sway for the past 8 years, including this one now that made it 9 years, there is nothing you can do. If you like, appoint APC members, the municipal council chairman, the permanent secretaries, and the rest of them. I can tell you, you are going to lose woefully. But I don't want the Nigerian people to lose guard. You must do your own bit. Because first, they have believed that they have broken the soul of the state, and the people are no longer willing to come out en masse and unleash their anger through the ballot, what we call the ballot revolution. They believed that come next election, with what they did through INEC, through the judiciary and security operatives, that the people will never dare to come out to challenge them come 2027. That is what they are counting on. But I tell Nigerians, if you give in to this, you are in for another disaster that many will never survive. I'm warning it now as I used to warn it before, like the voice in the wilderness. It is left for you to understand the importance of what we are doing. Not say I am talking too much here. We are saying this to open the eyes of Nigerians and to wake up your consciousness to see what is at stake. Because, now for our head, we will take Kariam. Get ready. The battle is not yet over until we free ourselves from these wicked, oppressive, blood-sucking demons parading themselves as your political leaders. Let me just leave it at that. Please help me share this video and create this awareness for Nigerian people not to give up and not to lose guard. Bye-bye for now.